Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to talk about the scalars and vectors. We are going to review back what we have learned in SPM MX, which is about the vectors. First is about the addition and the subtractions of the parallel vectors. Then you do addition when both vectors are in the same directions, or you do subtraction when both of them are in different directions. Next is for the addition or the subtractions of non-parallel vectors. So you have learned about the triangle law, parallelogram law, and also the polygon law to solve the related question in SPM. So for this video, I won't talk further about this because you should be expected to master this knowledge well in SPM. So I will suggest you to do revisions on the topic. So the next thing that we are going to talk about is the scalar and the vector product. So we also learned this topic again in the MaxTeam Semester 1, that you will do a lot of questions about it. For our part here, I will just go through the formulas and also the properties of the product. First is the scalar product, or also known as the dot product. So it is the product between two vectors that give you a scalar as a product. For example, we have learned about a vector, which is the product of the force and the displacement. So scalar product will consider the parallel components of the force multiply the displacement, which give the terms of cos theta in the formula. As you have already known that the work done or the energy is a scalar product, so the product between the force and the displacement must be a dot product. Next is the vector product, or also known as the cross product. The product is of course a vector which has a magnitude of the A multiply B multiply sine theta, where the theta is the angle between the two vectors. One example you could relate is about the Fleming left-hand rule that we have learned in Form 5 physics, which is used to determine the directions of the magnetic force when the conductor cuts through the magnetic field. So you will learn further about this in Semester 2 to calculate the magnitude and to determine the direction of the magnetic force. To cut it short, the magnetic force is equal to the current multiplied the cross product between the length and the magnetic field. So to determine the direction of magnetic force, so what you do is to apply your right-hand grip rule. So your finger should be rotated in the direction from the current to the magnetic field, which gives us the outward directions as shown in the picture. Let us see another diagram from the trial paper of Terengganu in 2021. Here, the vector Z is equal to X cross Y. So what you do is use your right hand and your finger is rotated from X to Y, and you will find out your thumb is pointing downward, which is the directions of the vector Z. So the next thing is about the resolutions of vectors, which we have learned something similar in the resolution of force in Form 5 physics. So it is just the applications of the trigonometry to resolve the force or the vectors into horizontal and the vertical components, which is 90 degrees to each other. So we will need to resolve the vectors a lot in this semester. So we'll discuss again about this in the other video. So the main thing I want to discuss in this video is about the applications of the vectors, which is specific to the operation of the subtractions. One of them is about the relative motions, which is something we have learned about in the electromagnetic induction in Form 5 physics. So relative motion is defined as the motion that results in the two objects becoming closer or becoming further away from each other. So there will be a relative motions when both of the objects moving with different velocity. Let's see one example here. So we have car A moves with constant speed of 40 meters per second toward east, and another car B moves with a constant speed of 30 meters per second toward west. So to calculate the velocity of A relative to B, so what we are going to do is to get the velocity A minus velocity B. And since both these vectors are in parallel, so we can just calculate 40 minus negative 30 directly, and the result is 70 meters per second toward east. In the other way around, the velocity of B relative to A is the velocity of B minus velocity of A. So we would have negative 30 minus 40 is equal to negative 70 meters per second, where the negative sign shows that the direction is toward west. So the calculation is quite straightforward if the vectors are in parallel. But what if the vectors are not in parallel? So let's see another example here. We have car A move toward east and another car B move towards north. So if we want to find out the velocity of A relative to B, what we have is the velocity of A minus the velocity of B. So since both of the velocity are not in parallel, so what we're going to do is to apply the triangle law to obtain the relative velocity. So we have VA minus VB, which we will get the directions as shown in the slide. And since this is a right angle triangle, so to get the magnitude, we just apply the Pythagoras theorem to obtain the value, which is 50 meters per second. And for the directions of the relative motions, you can just apply the varying. Then we're going to draw a line pointing to the north pole at the tail of the vectors. And from the diagram, we can apply trigonometry to obtain the angle, which is equal to 126.9 degrees. Next, we're going to find out the velocity of B relative to A. So what we do is just reverse the directions of the VA minus VB, which is equal to VB minus VA. So the magnitude of the relative motion is still the same, which is 50 meters per second. But for the directions, we need to redraw the north pole and obtain the new bearing. So from the diagram, you can apply the trigonometry and you should obtain the angle of 306.9 degrees. So there is another application which is about the change in velocity, which tested before an STPM Past Year in 2016. So in these questions, there's only one car involved, which has the initial velocity of 40 meters per second toward east and the final velocity of 30 meters per second towards north. So it is quite similar as the previous example. So the question here is, what is the change in velocity of the car? When you want to describe something change in physics, so it is the final value minus the initial value. So the change in velocity is equal to the final velocity, which is the 30 meters per second towards north, minus the initial velocity, which is the 40 meters per second towards east. So the vector of the change in velocity is equal to V minus U, which is the same as the second case of previous example. So to calculate the magnitude, it is the same that we just apply the Pythagoras theorem, since this is a right angle triangle. It is equal to 50 meters per second. And as for the directions, we're going to apply the bearing, then we should also obtain the angle of 306.9 degrees. So these are the two applications of the subtractions of vectors that you can expect in chapter one. And we'll learn to apply more in the next few chapters about the addition or the multiplications of the vectors. So that's all for my discussion today. If you still have any questions about vectors, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.